And we're back.
Hey.
Bam.
All right, so we just entered the temple. We were confronted with three fish people, one of whom looks to be a Super Saiyan.
That's
right.
With four arms.
Yes.
And I said, I held my hands out in a conciliatory gesture and said, blue, 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 blue. And then Teef wanted to persuade them of something.
I was going to persuade them, yeah. And then I've since realized it's probably not going to work because we don't speak the same language. I don't know enough to be able to, about the situation to be able to persuade them of anything.
Oh, I mean, so, body language, baby. Just don't draw your sword. Hold your hands up like, blue, 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 blue.
Yeah, I got to act like we're meant to be here and, yeah, blah, 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 blah. I'm pointing to somewhere over to behind them, you know, like. It's probably not going to work.
I don't know. If you have the confidence, it always works in my
you've got to have a high-vis jacket on and a clipboard, and you'll get in anywhere.
That is, God knows that's true. Teddy, does it work?
No.
Oh,
what a surprise!
Man.
I would like to
roll initiative.
Okay.
Don't forget to click your token.
I do every time. Hey. I forget that.
I've improved my roll.
Hey.
So many 20s. Jeez.
Man, we're beasts. Beast mode.
I mean, there was that 1-9, but.
Yeah, but that wasn't a real roll.
See, Hogan. Sahugan.
Hulk Hogan.
We're fighting fish Hulk Hogan.
Oh my god, it's the Baron.
When I first heard you say Sahugan, I heard, like, sea hoodlum. And I realized that they were definitely the bad guys.
Yeah, the Flump is with you as well.
Hey, Flump.
Can't really attack or anything.
Yeah, Flumps don't really. Yeah, they're just kind of chill.
Okay, well, descending. Hawkins apparently goes first.
Hawkins,
alphabetically.
Well, me or Teef.
You, please. You decide you. that by dexterity modifiers, but I think that both of you have the same dexterity, which is 20, right?
Yep.
Yes.
Beasts. All right, I guess it is alphabetical order. Hawkins?
Okay.
And technically, you're supposed to do a roll-off. It doesn't matter.
Well, but because we're in the same party, we can just say, hey, do you want to go first?
Yeah.
Like, okay. So, like, I even if I won, I would say I'll probably go second. So.
Fair enough.
Okay, I'm guessing that my bow and arrow isn't the best choice underwater. So I will, like, just walk up.
I didn't even think of that.
I will... I guess I'm making actions that sort of suggest you'd better start swimming, because I am going to mess you up to this giant fish man.
The thing that is, like, twice as tall as you.
Yep. I'm like, start running, son.
Start pumping those bunions. I'm coming.
Mm-hmm. You're going to be sushi. And I. Yeah, I've got two short swords, and I'm going to make an attack with both of them.
Hell yeah.
Hmm.
I think you can use, if you are two-weapon fighting, you can use your bonus action to make an attack at a penalty. Which is, you make it without your dexterity modifier.
Okay. So you is that a hunter thing or just a generic thing?
That's just how it's done. That's how two weapon fighting works in the game, is that it takes up your bonus action.
Okay.
So right, you can do it, but you subtract like 5 from the result.
Right. Oh yeah. Also, what type of animal or what type of enemy is this? Is this a beast or is it a?
Let me check. I think it's a humanoid.
Right. That's okay. Yeah, my favorite enemy is beasts. Sadly. Okay, so
right, so I subtract 5 from this.
I think that's how it works.
But surely that's, I mean, I get 2 attacks.
You'd have to roll another one and then subtract five, I think.
I shall do that. And there we go.
He gets three attacks.
He gets two plus a bonus action, which he's using to attack at a disadvantage. Or not disadvantage, but...
because you have extra attack, right?
Okay. Also worth noting, there's a section in the player's handbook about underwater combat, and we have been granted swimming speed by the flumph. A ranged weapon, so melee works. A ranged weapon is at disadvantage unless the weapon is a crossbow, a net, or a javelin, like a spear, trident, or dart.
Okay.
So cool. You could still use your bow, but you would be at disadvantage, and it would not make a lot of sense to do so.
Cool. I feel like I've made the right choice.
Yes.
Cool. The two last ones hit.
Uh-huh.
Let's see. How much health do these guys even have?
Probably about 15,
4?
Yeah, I would say, about 15. Sounds about right.
Right. Well, Chief.
Hello. It's my turn. Okay. You see, I wouldn't have gone and hit the big guy first, but now I kind of feel like I have to because...
No. I mean, look, I'm going to
right
mess
there, baby. Yeah.
Yeah, but that one on the right isn't close enough to him to get the sneak attack, you see. So now I'm just gonna have to hit the big dude.
Well, you should have told me.
It's all right. No, I'm not playing your character, man.
You could delay your turn until after I go.
Oh, that's true, because you're before them.
Small guys.
Yeah, let's do that. You go ahead of me.
Okay. I think that technically lowers your initiative to 21, but that doesn't matter one bit.
Yeah.
I will rush up.
To 20.
There we go. I will rush up and just slap this little tiny guy. He looks a little like Blanca, so I'm going to be on the lookout for electric attacks.
Who is that? Me? Hopefully not, but I think it was. Right.
And I'm just going to use my fists. With my two attacks.
Bang! Look at that. Bang.
I'm going to do another fist attack.
Oh.
First two hit. Looks quite damaged. Punched in the face.
Everyone's doing 15.
Teeth fly out. There's no floating in the water.
Right. Teeth is like swimming for those over here somewhere. Right here. Like, actually, I think I'm going to go on this side. Just nice. In case. And, first thing I'm going to do is grab one of those teeth. And then the second thing I'm going to do is try and skewer this thing on my rapier. Like that.
Poke it.
Mm. Not a great hit. I'm assuming I don't get a sneak attack, or do I? Do I have to hit to get the sneak attack?
You do have to hit to get the sneak attack.
Okay.
Remind me again how AC works.
If it is the same, it goes to attacker.
If it is the same, it goes to attacker. Is that with saving throws?
With saving throws, I think it is also ties also go to the attacker.
Okay, well, you hit.
Whew, okay.
Nice.
Well, in that case, I also get a sneak attack, so let's do that. Oh, yes.
Jesus, dog.
That's two of the dice rolls were crits. Jeez.
Well, the Suhugan just explodes.
Yeah. I'll say. I drew his attention, and then you just stabbed him right through the freaking...
you knocked his teeth out, and it, like, enraged me. Oh, teeth. I was like, gotta get those.
That was beast mode, dog.
Hmm.
That's probably the only attack on land now.
now, Hawkins, you should flap your wings a little like, ha, this is coming for you, bud.
Yep. Keep wings up that totally spread.
Yeah.
What have you got?
And all they're hearing
to spear you and then bite you.
Oh, God.
Damn it, Ted.
And none of those hit.
He's always got to be biting.
Now the big guy is angry because you've hurt him and his feelings.
Yep.
His feelings.
I raise my claws to him and just give him that little briefly come forward gesture.
He's holding like two tridents.
Like, that's less good.
I'm guessing. Let's see how. Okay. Let's change. Trident bite. What's your AC?
16.
Okay, I can't. 16. Okay, well, he hits you with a trident.
Okay.
He misses with the second trident attack, and you dodge his bite.
Good. Well, that was a good try, Dent, but no. I think I'm just going to ignore.
Hello?
The, hey. Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Is anyone out there?
Can you hear me?
No. Can you hear us?
I can. I can hear everyone, including Teddy.
Hi.
Is. I think Teddy's having some. Right,
let's wait until he's back.
Okay.
It's kind of important. Oh, Teddy, you missed it. He killed everyone in one hit. That's amazing.
The world's first GM-less D&D game.
Hello?
Hey. It's so sad.
We can hear you.
Oh, he's gone. It sounded so sad. Hello? Please?
Hello?
Can you hear us now? Testing, testing.
We cannot hear you.
Mic check. Mic check. He's gone again. I just realized anyone reading the Discord channel, scrolling back, be like, what were they talking about that went from picture of Blaze to pro rape, a Nigerian underwater.
And George Lucas.
George Lucas.
What was the thinking behind that, by the way?
Which one?
George Lucas.
We were talking about
you
that.
You guys were talking about Rogue thing. One, and then I mentioned that he had the blow tee.
Oh, right.
I think it was before Universal was here, actually. I can't remember.
Hello? Hello.
Hey.
You back? Cool.
Amazing. We did it. We did it. Yeah.
How much damage did I take, by the way?
You took
300 AC points.
13.
84.
13.
Piercing.
Okay. Tis but a scratch.
How much HP do you have? Fess up.
90.
God.
Jesus Christ.
Yep. And I'm a tough old bird. So, you know what? I'm just going to cast, as my bonus action, I'm going to cast my Hunter's Mark on the big dude, because I really should have done that first.
Did you do your real action yet?
No.
Okay. I thought I might have missed something then. Okay.
Sorry. So, with that, I attack.
Oh!
So, that gives me, Hunter's Mark gives me an extra d6 damage. Oh, why is spellbook? Right.
2d6.
Yeah, two more d6s. So. There's another 7.
So,
24.
In total?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well.
Does the Hunter's Mark. Oh, sorry.
You chop off one of its legs.
Yes.
Good God.
Nice.
I will drop one of my swords in favor of the leg. I am going to beat him to death with it.
What damage does the leg have, though?
Are you proficient with legs?
Yes, very.
That's my question.
Okay.
Really? A bird would be proficient with legs?
No, it's just Hawkins. You know, we've been on the road for like 4 years.
So that's happened. The Baron leg is 1d6, I believe. Damage done.
That sounds right. 1d6 bludgeoning damage.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna roll up on the big guy here and leave room for my pal Teef.
Oh,
yeah. Get in this party with us. And then I'm just gonna slap this guy repeatedly. Like, you know how E Honda does that thing?
Yeah. 100 hand slap.
Yeah. I think it's 1,000, but yes.
No, you can only do 100.
Oh,
it's underwater.
That is fair. That is fair.
They're both furiously tapping medium punch. That's the important thing.
Yes. And then I'm also going to blow a key point to slap him again. There we go.
Fantastic. Oh, there's a crit in there as well. Look.
Bam, bam, bam.
By me.
Punch its face so hard. Its head just flies off.
Whoa!
Oh.
Peace out.
Is that head full of teeth?
Yeah, but it's like
it's a fine
it's
mist.
Like flying, it's flying away at high speed. Oh, damn it.
What a weird.
Damn it, Rody. All right, then I'm gonna move over here, and assuming it's my go. Sorry, did you finish yours, Blaze?
Yes, I did.
Then I shall attempt to skewer our friend over here.
Poke him.
And I get my sneaky sneak attack. Like that.
He snook. Ooh. Hey.
Not as good that time.
Right. Looks good. Yeah.
Be worse.
Is he? Oh, Jesus, how much does it hurt? That's 19?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, he looks hurt. He's hurt and looks at you. He's like, I don't like you. Friends didn't like you either.
And look at where they are now.
He's going to try and claw at you. And bite you. And succeed. Wait, is that no wrong one? Claw bite. One, two. Right, that doesn't hit. That hits. Bites you. Take 5 piercing damage.
Just brings the teeth closer to him.
Mm-hmm.
To her, sorry. So could I cut his head off comically and just leave it sort of biting on your shoulder or whatever? That's what I'd like to do.
Sure.
Both short swords.
Too short.
Too sword.
It's off.
Yes.
Bam.
Right, I'm going to go to town with the pliers and get these teeth out of here.
I'm also still in like a battle rage, so I just run up to the flump and then throw a pie, and then I stop at the last second like, oh, sorry.
Like,
yeah. Oh, I moved away.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, Donald. And then I give him another little tentacle tickle.
A tentacle.
See, Donald, it's just that whenever you get our dander up, we kill everything. You know?
It's a tough old world, and we're tough old birds. Hawkins especially.
Caw-caw!
Yo, you are too sick to live.
That bite was 5 damage, did you say?
Yeah.
Okay, I haven't done that yet.
Okay. Well, so, let's see. Can I take a short rest just to roll a hit dice and get that back?
Short rest takes an hour.
Oh, is it that? Well, maybe not at this point then.
Yeah, you're screwed because Rody just marches in.
All right.
So short rest or no, we're just walking in.
I shall walk in, like Christopher.
You can also hawk in.
Oh.
As you walk in, you see that the pillars are very worn down. They don't. It doesn't seem like they can hold up much. And it's just the only thing that's keeping the ceiling from falling down is the fact that you're underwater.
Right. Okay.
Before you see, there's an entrance into a bigger hall. You enter this hall.
Oh dear.
Oh, he looks friendly.
I'm seeing a lot of teeth there.
Yep.
You come from the bottom. Anyway. You see this huge odd creature with all these tentacles. And in front of it is this huge sort of orb of swirling energy. The creature is holding up this sort of odd gem, like it's sort of floating in front of it, and it mouths something you can't really hear. The gem glows brightly, and the orb just the orb of energy just smashes and breaks in along with the gem. And you see that the orb was actually guarding what looks like this dark tome, which floats up to the big creature.
Well, could I introduce myself?
It notices you entering the room, and it's as it speaks, you hear it inside your mind. Oh, it's you.
Is this voice? Yeah, right.
You recognize it as the voice you heard after you killed the big tentacle creature.
Well, I'm sorry we're late to the party. But
book token down.
Ooh, a book token.
That's big. The big book of darkness.
Let's make it smaller. And it says, I hope you liked my present.
Well, it's funny because we got the same thing for you.
Which is an ass kicking.
If you have an ass, it's not really clear.
It's a tentacle kicking.
Yeah. Its mouth sort of curls into this sinister, horrific smile with all these teeth. And the book that's floating in front of it opens, and it again sort of speaks in whispers, which you can't exactly hear, and the flump. I forgot to do a bit of the flump was supposed to say something.
Okay, during the
film. Wait, can go back.
Sure.
He said that because the flump is able to absorb sort of psychic energies, it's also able to sometimes read sort of surface thoughts and memories to creatures it absorbed, and so it managed to get a few from this creature, and it figured out that it was going after what is called a book of keeping.
Okay.
it knows of this. It's a legendary artifact. There were four books of keeping, and now are all lost. Were created by a sisterhood of night hags for the archdevil. What is he called? What's the big archdevil dude?
Asmodeus?
Asmodeus. Yeah.
Rock me, Asmodeus.
And they were created along with an army of fiends that are called Yggdrasils. And,
I'm sorry, they're called Yggbits?
Yggdrasils. Write down Yggdrasils.
Yggdrasils. Right, is that what we're looking at right now?
No.
No? Okay.
Probably not.
He looks like a Yggdrasil.
Hugo.
Well,
Hugo Loth.
Please do make your acquaintance.
Each of the Hugo Loth's true names were written down in four books of keeping, and the witches used the books of keeping are used as sort of way to control the Yggdrasils, and if you speak its a Yggdrasil's true name, it will be summoned before you. But you need a book that contains its name to control it.
Mm.
And before the Sisterhood of Witches could bring the books to Asmodeus, sort of hags are very notoriously known for bickering a lot. And that bickering and fighting eventually led to them losing all of the books, and the books were sort of scattered and lost among the plains, sometimes found and then lost again, never kept.
Okay, so these, would we know these, know of these items? Would these sort of be legendary things?
The Flump tells you of this.
Right. Oh, okay.
It knows the legend, but it is you do sort of recognize it. It is a fairly known legend.
Right. Okay. So.
Yeah. Sorry. So the creature speaks something and whispers. You can't hear, and for. Now, three creatures appear in front of the altar.
Oh, no.
Poof.
Some poof. Foxman.
And poof.
Hmm.
Hi, guys.
That looks like one of those Ant-Man things from what are they called? Ankegs? No? I don't know. I forget.
I mean, I can tell you about kegs. I don't know about Ankegs.
I'm not sure what the other one on this side is. This guy looks like a fox.
That's Sly Cooper.
We can get him to steal some stuff for us, starting with that book.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so these guys look threatening, I take it?
Well, they look sort of confused and annoyed, and then the creature again speaks loudly, but you can't understand language. It's like... It's when it opens its mouth and speaks, it's like, along with the words, it's like fire is coming out of its mouth.
Hmm.
And
as it finishes, would that be like demonic language? Sorry. Maybe.
Maybe. Do you know of any demonic languages?
No. Well, unless Draconic would work. I do know a bit of Draconic.
No, it is not Draconic.
Okay.
Oh, I might.
You're a tiefling. You're...
don't know what... Infernal, I know.
You know Infernal?
Common and Infernal.
This changes a lot. I have to rethink major plot points now. I didn't count you know Infernal. Okay, well, you do understand it. And the creature says, just commands them to kill you, basically.
Right. So could I tell the creatures we're on their side?
Can attempt to.
Oh, that persuasion.
You can say...
let's see if I can roll it.
This asshole has just taken you from your comfy hill dimension or wherever you're from.
Let's team up and bring it down.
Ooh.
Nice. Not bad.
I'm expert at it, not just proficient. Because I'm the manager of the band.
I wish I could get good rolls on things I have expertise in.
It's great. I recommend it.
Keep rolling you nines on my perception. Yes.
You tell them that you try and convince them, but they don't even flinch at your words and keep approaching. And the creature says, "Fools, you these fiends are not controlled by words."
Do you think we could control them with an ass kicking?
Ha ha! Let's get them.
Is this still all completely underwater, by the way?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Cool. Roll initiative.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh man, I always forget to click my token.
24. Love that ability.
Yeah, that really is pretty nice. Ultraloth. Jesus. We can't
anything
handle
with ultra in the name.
Yeah, bad. I definitely can't handle an ultraloth. I'll tell you that for free.
Descending.
Man, we rolled really poorly. Mm-hmm. And somehow I'm second with a 9.
This dude, what does he look like? I'm having trouble even when I'm the one on the right.
Well, I can just show you.
He's sort of a humanoid-ish.
Oh, hi. Oh, what a cutie.
Yeah.
Hey, bud.
Interesting.
I like his sword a lot.
Pretty good. I wonder if I could have it. Well, I'm going to find out. I'm going to go for him. And, let's see. Wait a second. No, it's okay. Right, I'm just going to stab at him. Okay, 14 and 19. Plus, I'll spend my bonus attack, so that's minus 5 to whatever I roll, isn't it?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. Ooh. That's...
minus 5, that's an 18. Okay, well, it skillfully dodges your first one. You manage to scrape its arm with the second one and again miss with the third one.
Uh-oh.
Yikes. Okay. This is a bit of a bad one. Okay. Well, that's good to know.
Dealt 11 damage to it. Actually,
yeah.
Okay. Next is Teef.
Okay. I'm going to move up. if I get the right thing selected. I'm going to stand over here, just off to the side. I'm going to attack the same one with my rapier.
Sneaky.
And also the sneaky sneakers. Yeah.
Hey.
It'll do.
Pretty powerful, though. Even.
Managed to stab it. Again, it seems like doesn't seem to even flinch at your attacks.
Yikes.
Do you want to use your cunning action for anything, Scoop?
What's cunning action?
Dash, disengage, or hide.
I can. Yeah, I think I'm going to hide. I'm going to, like, can I take a step and hide? So, like, move to the pillar and try and hide behind it? Does that work?
Disengage?
Yeah, I have this thing.
Well, you can either disengage or hide.
Oh, right, okay.
With cunning action.
Then I'm going to hide.
Okay.
You can't see me. Maybe.
Do you need... I think you, that's a hide action, so you need to roll stealth.
Did I? Oh, okay, damn it.
Sure. I'm not actually sure how hide works. Keys is a rogue
as well,
but like Keys is a rogue, but he doesn't hide for shit.
I'll try it.
He's too busy yelling at people.
Hello?
Hello? Oh, hey. Yeah, you rolled. just looking at stuff. Can you manage to hide from it for now?
Okay. So, Rhodey's up.
Give you a hidey thing.
Ooh. Look how hidden.
Okay, so as a monk, I've got mad movement. And I'm going to use it real for serious. All right, so here's 30 feet. And here is 40 feet. And I'm going to use I'm going to grab out of my bag my grappling hook.
Yeah.
And I'm going to try to get the book out of this thing's hand.
Okay.
Nice.
Do you want me to make like a thrown weapons attack or like, what do you...
How to say grappling hook? Yeah, mm-hmm. Sure, make me like a thrown weapon attack.
Okay, that should be an unskilled dex because I'm not actually proficient with grappling hook. So I'm gonna do an unskilled dexterity throw.
Okay.
Nope.
Yeah. That does not hit. I didn't actually put the...
Would you maybe get your proficiency bonus or something?
I should not have it because...
He's unskilled.
I don't know... Well, I am extremely skilled. Wait.
Well, that's debatable, really.
No, wait, hang on. Actually, you just opened up my eyes to something very important.
It probably still wouldn't have hit anything.
All right, so I rather than throw that grappling hook, and I'm sorry because I already did that, I would like to use my action to instead make myself proficient in grappling hook.
Okay, sure.
Cool. Thank you for letting me retcon. I really appreciate it. I move over there and I pray to the goddess Thera, guide my hand on this grappling hook, this holy grappling hook
of Antioch.
Of Antioch.
You just don't get prayers like this in real life.
You do, but it never affects anything.
Damn. No, but you know. Yeah, that is true. I wish people like kind of went the extra mile with their praying. All right, so that's the end of my turn.
Okay. Well, Okay, well, how much damage does this deal? Okay, let's be just the fox dude, your Kenneloth. Is going to cast a spell, which is it's going, you see lightning four minutes pause.
Fuck! Oh. What?
There.
Hang on, we're underwater.
Yes.
Yeah, the only thing about underwater is that it negates all fire damage.
No, I'm pretty sure it'll lightning damage. It'll make it so that it hits everyone.
Oh, good.
Huh.
So everyone give me a dex save.
Oh dear. Right, come on. Where is my dex save? Here we go. Oh!
Jesus.
That's not good.
Okay, well, Universal, you...
Yeah?
Are dead now. Actually,
explode.
He's got loads of health. He's fine.
Kentucky Fried Hawkins.
The lightning hits you extremely hard, and
I don't disagree.
You lose motor function partially. You now have the slow effect.
Oh man.
As if you have been hit by a slow spell.
Okay, and that takes me down 47 as well.
Yes. Let me look up what a slow spell does. Slow.
Is it half speed or?
So screw you. You have a thing, don't you?
Yeah, because I save on a roll of a dexterity. I will just show you this.
Yeah, you actually take no damage whatsoever. Scoo is fucking gold and he's hidden.
Okay. The lightning also hits the other two Yugoloths and Kenala. They don't seem to...
Please fail badly.
They flinch, but it doesn't seem to hurt them as much as it hurts you.
Bastards.
Let me actually see how they do.
Uh-huh.
It's only D. Okay. So that means, Jesus, what is going on with these windows? Okay. So these two take this much. Actually, I really should have a calculator because these numbers are pretty annoying. Calculator windows, come on. There.
If only we had computers or something.
Okay. What's that one? That's this one. This one, it's not gonna take anything. Next, the little bug dude. is going to fly over, well, it's going to walk over, swim over to you, Rhodey, and it is going to, let's see.
Has anybody else noticed that the Arcana Loth just served the function of friendly fire?
Maybe we should recruit him.
He will fit right in.
I'm looking forward to this TPK. So wait, that was on me, I assume.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm down. There we go.
Whoa.
What do you mean?
I'm at 0 hit points.
You are at 0 hit points.
I'm at 0 hit points. I took 47 damage from the Arcana Loth. And now I have taken 17.
Oh, shit, I didn't actually... okay. You're at 0 hit points.
Right.
Next, the Ultra Loth is going to... let's see what
I can do. Well, Scoot essentially run away and hid.
So. Yeah, you're kind of...
Can he heal Rhodey? Does he have any healing spells?
I actually do have Cure Wounds.
I don't actually know how the death thing works.
Right, but ideally Ultraloth would heal me with his action.
Ah, yes, yes. Possible. Oh, yeah, I see. Oh, I have to be touching to heal.
The Ultra Loth. Trying to find something that won't actually just kill all of you. It's proving difficult.
I think you're going to have to go with it.
It's going to disappear. How do I make the token not visible?
Move it to the GM layer, right-click it, and under layer.
Oh. Boop.
Where did it go?
That's me gurgling on my blood.
Okay, right. Let's see. So I'm slowed. Let's see.
Yeah,
I can't really move. That's the maximum I can move.
Let's see. So your speed is halved. Minus 2 to the AC and dexterity saving throws. Can't use reactions. You can use either an action or a bonus action, not both.
Right. I'll use my action to attack this.
The flum. Before you start your turn, the flump yells at all of you. Get the book.
Was trying.
Okay, it's hold on. Only Let's hope. See.
It hides behind the pillar.
Right.
Does that flump have any healing magic? Just wondering, for a friend.
You don't see it using any.
Okay, so if you could sneak up there, Scoo.
That's the plan.
Yeah. I mean, I could try and run up there, but obviously I'm slowed, so...
Yeah, it would take you about 3 goes to get up there. 3 rounds, I mean.
Right, okay. So...
It would take me 1.
That case...
You could attempt to shoot the book out of it.
Could do.
At a disadvantage. It'd be like Robin Hood style.
Okay, so beginning at 8th level, I can use the dash as a bonus action on my turn. So I will do that.
But you can only use an action or a bonus action.
That's true. Okay, tell you what. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to move up here. I'm going to cast Cure Wounds on myself. And I'm going to try and run interference on these two guys. I'm going to be like, hey, assholes! Why don't you pick on someone? I'm
gonna say that wounds. Removes your slow effect, your wounds.
Okay, cool. I like it.
Right. How much health do you gain?
Okay, so I am... Spellbook, where is it? Cure Wounds. I can show this, can't I? Okay, so I want to cast it as a second level spell, essentially. Heal myself for 2d8. Plus spell casting. Right, okay, so... Okay, so that's not brilliant, but 9 plus 4.
You sure you don't want to do that on, like, me, or...
I honestly wouldn't, but I have to be touching you, and I can't get over there in time. Mm. So I'm going to do that on you next turn, if I can get over.
Oh, you're so sweet. I'm sorry. I should have known better than to doubt you.
Never doubt me. You live longer. Oh, I just took health off myself. 43. Okay. Right, and that is my go done.
Right, I'm going to move up here, 30 feet.
Yeah.
And I'm still hidden. That is my full movement, but I'm going to try a sleight of hand. Is it sleight of hand? What would I need? It would sleight of hand.
It would be sleight of tentacle.
But it's my hand and his tentacle. So I think it's tentacle my slightly hand. Handing. So let's see if this gets it.
Let's see if it does.
Could go either way.
I honestly don't know how you, what happens with sleight of hand. Does I have to beat something, or?
Jesus Christ, didn't put his stats in either.
Oh, I know this one. He's got 0 dex, 0 strength, 1 int.
1 int.
He has actually 9 dex.
Yeah, like I said.
Slash.
Maybe you should just do an opposed roll.
Well, you managed to do it.
Yay! Yes!
As you do it, suddenly all... Both the Arcanoloth and the Mesoloth immediately turn their attention from you to Diabolus, and they look furious.
Now, because I can understand Infernal, am I able to read any of this book to, like, figure out how it works? Or
don't read it. Yes. Take no time. Listen, guys, the rest of this temple. Book of the Dead. Well, here's the thing. The rest of this temple is about to fall down during this fight. You remember that the columns outside were, like, toothpick thin? We've got 3 things that love to fuck shit up, and a 4th thing that loves even more to fuck shit up about to, like, make the party go down, and I'm dead. So, like, can you drag my body the fuck out of here before this entire temple falls apart?
I was going to control one of these
and
dudes
then,
to
and
maybe
then
heal
you can read it after well, that.
See, it sounds like they're furious with the Aboleth, so, you know, they're going to go after him. So that gives us a wee window to do the things that we want to do with our lives. Specifically, okay. Continue them.
I'm going to take a step. Can I do that? But I think I can. With my cunning, whatever it's called.
With your cunning action, you can take a disengage, or you can just straight up dash, because you didn't... Like,
oh,
you
that's
didn't,
true. I'm
you didn't
not
attack.
In combat.
Yeah, like if you're... Right. If
so
you're
what's
not.
A dash? Is the dash half your movement?
It's your movement again.
Oh, is this a full thing? In that case, I'm going to run back the way I came, which was down here. Obviously, the book's coming with me, but I can't move that. Hmm. Okay. Actually, no, hang on. I've run the wrong way. I want to run this way to help Roti.
Roti. Right.
Roti. Well, you used your action.
So. Yeah. Okay. This is
Roti
cunning
action. Does Roti actually do anything? Oh, this is a cunning...
What
are you doing?
Well, I moved to get the book. I got the book... was my action, then I used my bonus action, which is this thing, which lets me dash with the book over towards Rhodey.
Okay. Yeah, sure. So Rhodey can't do anything, does he?
No, not right now, but the plan is, I guess, that Hawkins on his next go might be able to heal him. Actually, I think doesn't Rhodey get to roll dice or something, and he has to get
make a death saving throw?
Yeah.
I can do that. Okay.
Just don't roll a one, dude.
Oh!
Whoa! Okay, I think that's fine, as long as it's not a one.
Yeah, that goes against, that's like a mark against him.
Yeah, there are three total.
He gets two more of those, he is dead.
Right. You should get to him before that.
Yes, certainly.
No, don't worry about it, guys, I'm cool here. It's all right.
You see the Kananov start slowly walking towards the creature and shooting firebolts at it. And the bug also goes over and starts slashing at the creature. And let's see, this guy.
We can't see the other one.
Did he manage to break his control or something?
Starts attacking. Well, you remember from the story that you need
the book to be able to control.
Yeah, I was just thinking maybe he broke free before we got the book. I don't know.
No, it's your turn, Universal.
Okay, well, I am going straight over. 1, 2, 3. Yep, that is good. And I cradle Roti's head in my wing. And I roll a level 2 Cure Wounds spell.
Just as you're doing that, I want to position myself so I've got my pliers out as if I was going to take his teeth. Just for a joke, so when he wakes up, that's what he sees.
Oh, nice.
And then I'd be like, oh, hi, yeah, no, you're fine. Assuming this one.
Okay, so that's 17 health back.
Okay, I my eyes flutter open and I slap the pliers away as I tenderly stroke your beak. Thank you.
Okay. You're all right now.
Thank you.
We've got to get out of here.
This has got you. Okay.
Well, I mean, if we're just chilling in here, I do have a question. Is there more goodies to be had over here? Or is that just not really part of the map?
You've just been brought back from the brink.
I as a player have that question. How brave are you guys feeling?
Well, you've hardly got any health. I think Uni's blown his healing spells.
You see the tentacle creature and the three Yugulas finding each other. It seems like the tentacle creature is losing very hardly.
I mean, here's the thing. We've got the book, and if the tentacle creature loses, we've got the book. And we can tell them to fuck off and go back to where they came from, because you know Infernal. Provided this thing doesn't actually bring the house down, are we seeing any structural integrity damage to the temple here?
Yes, these two pillars are pretty much gone.
All right, so how brave are you guys feeling is the question. Because we're Gucci, like nothing is going to attack us directly, except that the building may collapse onto us.
Do we take this time to get out of here? Or, I mean, it would be nice to make sure this thing's dead.
Here's the thing. He who dares wins.
That is true. Heroes aren't made playing it safe.
He who dies loses.
That's also true. I'll take it. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm fine. I've got loads of health because I didn't take 47 lightning damage. But
yeah.
I mean, I don't have loads, but I got more than you.
That's true. That's true.
So if you're game free, I'm fine.
Why don't you use your mammoth amount of movement and go and investigate that other? Because you've got the ability to move, then dash, then take another dash. You can move 90 feet.
But I've just ended my go, haven't I? Or are we out of combat?
Oh, never mind. If you just took your turn, then I will take mine and move my 40.
Hang on, did I? No, wait.
No, I just took mine and healed.
That's right, we had a whole one around. Yeah, no, we're back round again, that's what it is. Yeah, so now I can move. Yeah, okay. How far is that then? So, well within it. I'll go and have a peek through the doorway, and then I've got a dash to get back if... Imagine the book's with me.
Mm-hmm.
What do I see?
A sarcophagus.
Nope, we're going.
Yeah, that sounds about right to me. Yep, mm-hmm.
Who dares wins?
Oh man, that is some dare win right there. The dare win awards. Fuck it, let's go.
Do you want me to resurrect the fucking monkey?
No, like inside that sarcophagus is some sweet treasure.
Or just like a thing that's going to kill us.
Yeah.
Or a new member of the band, because I've got this book and it might like... I've seen the film The Mummy. I know how this works. You read from a book and suddenly things become yours, right?
You're basically Brendan Fraser IRL, so yeah.
All right, teeth gestures for you guys to come over then.
Let's do this shit!
Yay!
All right, I spend my turn getting all up in... Actually, how far can I move from there to there? I can basically go there. Let's call that close enough.
Okay.
I can move like way more than that because I can take the dash action. So I'm like 40. I'm over way outside the pasteboard.
Yeah, I could be as well, but I obviously couldn't because there's no board that way.
Yeah, got it.
Okay, well, you get to the sarcophagus, except Universal. It's, mm-hmm. With this cheeky movement, it's not your turn.
Oh, sorry.
Meanwhile, the Yugolos.
That's my intention.
They've pretty much won the battle. They're pretty much finishing the big tentacle creature off.
Nice.
Your turn, Universal. You may move.
I'm just noticing a sarcophagus at the north of the room as well. Which I hadn't noticed because I was scrolled down a bit.
Yeah. Oh, we can just let that fall apart. That's fine.
Why is that one... Like,
because they want to the room. Are broken. We gotta. Oh, geez. Okay, maybe we should. I don't. Oh, I got.
Let's see. This bit falls down.
Oh, yeah. Like
keeps in.
Okay.
Is this room ahead of us a dead end, or is there like a way out from the other side, or?
Are there windows we could jump or fly
through?
Yes,
there is a window. It would be a tight squeeze, but you can make it.
Well, I'm small, so...
Yeah.
I'm quite petite. It's just if Universal's wings can fit through.
Yeah,
might have to cut them off, but, you know.
I can wrap them around myself and just be a little hairy missile.
Yeah, I mean, if you've ever seen, like, a hawk, like, actually flying through... Hairy? I think it's more feathery. But there are YouTube videos of a hawk going through like in possibly narrow spaces because they're mad dope at that shit.
There you go.
Let's do this. Let's head in. We're gonna open up the sarcophagus. Whoa. My dog's
gonna bring the dog. Bring the dog. Flumph, come this way. A gesture for Flumph.
Oh, yeah. Flumph.
Okay. Oh, Flumph, you sound like a dog.
Flumph is very upset.
Yeah. That's a good boy.
It's okay, Flumph. It's all right.
Oh. How do I give you control over this token?
You can right-click on it, hit the cog, and then say can be controlled by, and then it should be like all players.
Okay. All players. Bam. It's yours. Okay.
Can't click it.
It doesn't matter. Come on.
I know, I'm just saying. Carry on. Next room. Let's go. Let's do it.
We hoist so open the sarcophagus.
You're at the sarcophagus. Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
Right.
And inside of it, you find...
A sweet treasure.
You find some...
Some maidens.
Huh. Unexpected.
You find some wet gloves.
What?
Oh my god, this is where Michael Jackson was buried.
Some extremely wet leather gloves.
Hmm.
The gloves are probably good for punching with, so I'm gonna
yeah.
I'm gonna scoop them up, and then we're all gonna take off toward that window.
Yep, it's window time.
Sure.
You call me Microsoft.
You all manage to go. You all manage.
All right.
To get through.
Is Flump through?
Yes. Good. You see the temple caving in behind you.
I don't even turn back to look. I just keep swimming.
God, that's boss. Wow.
Clutching the book closely.
Cool guys don't look at implosions.
Okay, well, you're out.
All right, I say to the Flump, was that your man back there? How are you feeling?
I got the address wrong.
Well, I mean, the thing is that the flump felt the psychic disturbance in the force. So yeah. If we did our jobs right, then it's kind of done with, right?
It's gone. It's gone.
Okay. Tell your people you're free now.
That was an aboleth.
Good lord.
An aboleth.
I'm gonna tickle those tentacles.
They haven't been seen for. And it's, I can't even say a number. It's been so five? Much, so long.
more than five?
They shouldn't be able to get here. The plane where they exist is locked off.
What plane are they from?
The far realms.
Sounds like it's a fair distance away.
Certainly more than the near realms.
There's supposed to be a blockade on the firearms that into other planes.
Well, who would know about this sort of stuff? Or who would sort of... Would there be anyone who knows about, you know, linkages between planes and that sort of stuff?
What about the book?
Oh, yeah.
Would you like to open the book and read it?
Are we still underwater? Guys, let's
yes.
prioritize here.
Yeah, I thought we got out, didn't we? Did we make it to the shore?
We made it out of the temple.
Oh, right, okay.
Would you like to swim to the shore?
Absolutely.
I want to ask the Flump first. Yeah, is the Flump okay with this? Like, go tell your people what's good after we swim to shore?
What people?
Your friends in the village underwater. Your friends in the village underwater that were mind controlled by this aboleth.
They weren't my friends. I was somewhere else. I was deeper underwater.
Oh, can you look?
Where the psychic beings live.
Cool. Wow. Psychic things live underwater?
Some creatures. Well, I need psychic energy. Some creatures deep underwater. Have enough psychic energy for me to be able to sustain myself.
That's really cool. I'm going to give him a little tentacle rub and then tell him to go tell the village that they're free, even though he hasn't met any of them.
Or can you do
that? Can you do that for me, boy? Can you do it? Can you do it?
I'd rather not go to the village full of angry fish people who worship shark gods.
Yeah.
Bloodthirsty shark gods.
Okay. All right, Donald. You're right. You're right. Go be safe and enjoy yourself. Thanks for the water breathing. That was really helpful.
Wait.
Yeah.
I like you.
I like you too, bud. I like you too, Donald.
Let's say... Takuna's character, Leon. Like, I'm assuming like that the party members who aren't here are here, but just not sort of doing anything.
Sure, however you want to handle it. Yeah.
They might have been helping out at Hoarfrost that was on fire or something while we
broke
off. So the Flump says that your friend there, he has I feel psychic energy within him. If, like, I could say, it wouldn't do any harm to him, but I could stay along and feed off of him.
Maybe Ambrose could help out, because he's quite good with magic. I can't remember.
The magic, more the psychic energy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yummy, delicious psychic energy.
Oh, I give him a little tentacle tussle.
I can be of great help. I know many things of history and lore.
I'm all for keeping him around. He's quite cool.
Let's do that. Let's change his name from Donald to Exposition.
Sure.
Anyway, okay, so what happens when Scoo starts reading through this book?
Well, basically it's just a book of names. The Yugoloth's true names. Seems to be like hundreds and hundreds of them in this single book.
This is a so this is a demonic phone book.
I was thinking demonic baby name book.
I'm gonna keep hold of this thing then. It's gonna be useful.
Yeah. Look up some old friends in the hell dimensions.
Every time someone I check in the book. Are they in here?
It's usually Yugoloth, so.
What about the gloves? Are they just regular gloves? Should we get them appraised?
I can cast Identify automatically.
Okay, you do that. They are magical gloves.
Ooh!
Which increase your punching ability by 1 damage.
Delightful. I want to put those bad boys on and look sharpish.
They were cursed. Your hands fall off immediately. Your hands turn into feet so you can kick things.
Let me make sure that this works as intended. Okay. Yeah, there we go. All right, cool.
Definitely have monsters that look like gloves.
You should change it to gloved fists.
You're right.
So in case someone ever takes the gloves off you, you can use your normal fists.
Deal. Bingo. All right, cool. I got some gloves to beat people with. And I'm immaculately well-dressed, so like adding gloves is just like, like that extra little bit of sharp.
Showbiz fresh. Does this book have a title so I can put it in my inventory?
It's the Book of Keeping.
That's right. I knew you said it earlier and I couldn't remember what it was.
And then in parentheses, you can put demonic phone book.
Also, you do realize that you live an army of Yugoloths at your hands here.
Hell yeah. Oops.
Well, we'll see. Maybe I don't realize it yet in character.
Maybe you don't like doing that sort of thing. Like, especially as a tiefling, it depends on like... So with tieflings, they've got like weird childhoods, right? Because everybody's like mad racist about them and distrust them because of their demonic heritage. And yet here you are a hero. So blah, blah, blah. And the way that you relate to your... allegedly or perhaps truthfully demonic heritage is going to kind of dictate your relationship to this book. So that's like, I know that you basically just came up with this character as an excuse to steal teeth because it's funny.
Well, hang on. We've got the backstory for the teeth now as well. So
yeah, sort of, but I mean, it's a matter of like kind of fleshing out who Teeth actually is apart from like being a pun name. Which is, of course, Teef, the tiefling Teef.
Yeah, she likes having
tiefling Teef.
The knowledge and stuff. So I don't think she's like, it's not so much about that. She likes taking things and having them. It's not necessarily like she's going to use it as a weapon or anything, but it's yeah. it's certainly a cool book that she's definitely going to hang on to.
I mean, we may not have use for armies, but backup singers?
I just realized she's also carrying the Golden Fiddle trophy. What was that from? Was that from the... That was
the Universals. Yeah, that was the heist that we did. That was the Ballroom Blitz.
I couldn't remember why I had it. There we go.
The heist that turned into actually legally obtaining the item.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And then, like, the other guy kind of falsely heisted the false thing.
Yeah.
So, whoops for him.
Heisted a heister. So, okay.
Very cool. Very good game, Ted. Another banger.
I mean, you can continue if you want to.
Oh, let's fucking do it. Yo, all right. So we're heading out. We've gone to the shore. Yeah, we've gone to the shore. We've got a flumph. Let's go to Horfrost and see if...
I'll say that a flumph counts as like a familiar creature for Leon.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
I'm going to give him a tentacle. I'm going to gently tentacle him to the ground and then say, what next? And I'm going to shake him.
How would we find out about the integrity of the barrier between our plane and that plane?
The foreign realms aren't really connected directly to the material plane. It must have... traveled through the other planes and gone all the way back here.
So has Horfrost been completely decimated, or is it just parts of it? It's just gone.
Gone.
Here.
Jesus.
So, like, but this is 4 years on from the other timeline, right?
Yeah, this is like entirely... Okay.
So we can go back to enjoying Horfrost.
Yes.
For 4 more years.
Just right. Don't make any serious friends.
Yeah, we're in days of future past.
We could be like in a dimension. Like it doesn't have to be the same world as the...
Four years is plenty of time in D&D land, though.
Yeah, we can put it all together. I like the idea of having it all in the same place.
That's cool. It's cool.
Horfrost is just where most people, where you guys are used to hanging out. It is not like, I don't think anybody actually came from Horfrost. I don't know that anybody, like, apart from the mayor and the bartender at Horfrost are major characters. So it's fine to murk it. So we discover the clues from this fish village. Can we ask the flumph to maybe take us down to that village and see if they've, because we need to verify now, right, whether that thing actually worked, whether that thing that we just fought and murdered was the source of their flip out.
Okay.
Sweet. By the way, would that count as our rest?
Yeah, let's take a rest on shore. Let's take some shore leave.
Yes.
Sure, you can rest. Okay. Shore, you can rest.
Ha ha! Like Ryu, sure you can.
I used to think he said, because it was always Ryu or Ryu,
Ryu.
Who would say it, that I used to think he was saying, hey, you can.
Well, yeah, he is, because...
No, are you Ken?
Are you Ken? Yeah,
are the you other... Ken?
Yeah, his buddy is Ken.
That's what I mean, like, forgetful. Like,
yeah, he's got that crazy thing where you can't recognize faces. And he's like, are you Ken? Because I'm just looking for my pal, who I've trained with.
And then when he realizes
years.
It's not, he punches him.
Yeah, that makes really good sense. Although you still punch Ken. In the game.
That's true.
It's complicated.
No, he says, how do, Ken? And a ball of fire.
That's asking how you are, and then Ken's like, yo, I need I need hot tea. Can you help me out?
What the fuck?
And then he gives him a fireball to warm his tea with. Okay, so we sleep for 8 hours in the shitty remains of the inn. And find that to be a tragedy. And then we ask the flump to give us that water breathing sweetness. And let's head down to the fishing village. Or the fish village.
The Sahugan village.
The Sahugan.
The
sea.
The Sahugan.
The Sahugan.
it's all tied in. We're in the same universe as Street Fighter.
We're going to go down to the sea. We're going to go down and see the sea hooligans.
Well,
and ask if they're okay.
You notice that there's a pack of them going over to the ruins of the temple that was destroyed. They're sort of digging, trying to remove the rocks.
Let's observe passively for a little bit and see what okay. they dig up, because
once they've dug up, you see the Yugoloths are nowhere to be seen.
Oh.
And
hmm.
They sort of attempt to pull the Aboleth corpse from the
wreckage,
ruins,
right.
And they lead it sort of further away from shore, deeper into the ocean.
Let's follow.
Yeah.
Okay. You see that they come near a pack of literally a pack of sharks, and they sort of leave the corpse there, and the sharks all come over and start eating the Yabalus.
Well, that's bad meat. You don't want that.
All the Sahugans sort of watch and dance and cheer.
Hmm. Well, I'm sure they know what they like.
I don't know. I think we're going to have to maybe just fuck these guys up real bad. Like, I am not happy with the fact that they roasted our horf, is my problem.
True, but then it was the Aboleth who did that to them, wasn't it?
The Aboleth was
I mean, there's never any trouble before this between the places that we knew of.
You know that the village was there, but they never actually even came onto the shore.
Yeah.
So it is worth knowing that a group of sharks can be called a shiver of sharks.
Yeah, that is a cool term.
Shiver.
That is even cooler than a school. It's too cool for school, is what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, so we know that the enormous bad guy got eaten by sharks. We don't know what happened to the smaller but way more powerful than us bad guys. Is this correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Although then again, I would add that they didn't seem to be controlling themselves at that moment. Not saying that they're good guys, but they were more keen on taking their revenge on the Aboleth.
Sure, but they're like distinctly evil. Like, I would... Can we... Is there a way by which we can divine the names? So Scoo was listening. Tief was listening when the Aboleth conjured forth these beings.
Yeah, but none of you could hear it. He sort of whispered it.
Ah, shit. So we don't know. Like, maybe you can go through the whole book of like the thousand names and just be like, you go home, stay there. You go home, stay there. You go home, stay there for like everybody.
Well, I mean, you'd have to speak them first and then they would be summoned in front. Then you'd have...
Yeah, it's like X Factor.
You'd have to summon
like a waiting
all
room.
Of the thousands of
now euros. Serving customer number 3.
I think we're just going to have to leave these extremely dangerous things in the world for a
while. Yeah, no, let's leave them roaming free. That's fine. They didn't specifically mean us harm.
Or should we introduce ourselves and just say, hey, this is what happened to yous? No harm done. Well,
I mean,
not exactly no harm done, but
a pretty fair amount of harm has been done, yeah.
I mean, if you had killed a bunch of people, wouldn't you want to know?
I'm not one of those things.
Okay, let's just leave him.
All right, I think we're going to have to call it here, right? Like, I don't know of any further way we can move to forward the action.
No, I think we would maybe regroup with everyone else back at Horfrost and sort of fill them in.
Horfrost, yeah. Sir.
Horfrost.
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 Well, basically, I didn't actually plan anything. So, if, like, this is from this point, this is sort of it's your decision where to go and what to do.
Yeah. Okay. So, well, I mean,
you guys all hooked up right with the rest, so.
Yeah, we'll regroup real quickly. Fiddles, but... how do we go about finding the other 4 books? Or the other 3
other
books?
Other 4 books.
What books?
There are 4 books, books of keeping.
Yeah.
There are
oh, right,
other
okay.
3 books that we need to find, lest an Aboleth summon an army.
Well... the other 3 books are just... completely. I mean, nobody knows where they are. Many, many people want to know where they are. Peter would like to acquire a book of keeping simply for like the power that is an army of Yugoloths, but
yeah.
I think Roti will spend some time communing with the goddess Thera. Asking that she gift him with divine knowledge and see how that goes.
Sierra is the goddess of...
She is the goddess of expertise, talent, skill, and knowledge.
Okay. So... do you know, is she an in the universe?
Did
you make her up?
I made her up.
Okay, can you tell me like which outer plane she's from?
I don't know. I can do some research and get back to you.
Okay. Well, tell me her alignment.
She is fully good. She is lawful good.
Good neutral, lawful good.
Goody two shoes.
Sort of more good than lawful, equal measure.
More good than lawful.
Okay, so given
that you work
was...
for criminals.
Let's see, outer planes.
I guess she would have to be from... Wow. Okay. Whoa, I didn't even realize that this planes thing was in the player's guide, but there's like hella shit going
on
there.
There's a nice wee map or something of the planes, isn't there?
Yeah.
Wow.
There's basically like a plane for like how many? 16 or something?
Yeah, wow. This looks it looks like she would be hanging out in like Bytopia, perhaps? Mount Celestia, maybe?
Hmm.
Oh, look, the lower planes. D demons, devils, and Yugoloths. So yeah, I'd be well up about this. Man, being infernal.
Yeah, we need to learn some shit. We need to learn us some planes, people.
I'm assuming she's from Bytopia.
Sure. Let's take that.
Well, she tells you that what you hold before you is extremely powerful and both extremely dangerous. You should expect that others will come seeking it. She says that the Abolus' presence in the outer planes has drawn many powerful creatures' attention to its mission, and many now know of the location of the Book of Keeping.
We're gonna have some shit just happen to us. Okay.
We need to stay on the road.
As for the other Books of Keeping, she does not know any about where they could be.
I thank her and offer her my worship and love. I've actually got to go and walk this fucking dog, but I'm all about this little mystery taking place.
Well, should this be something we pick up on next time?
Sure. Next time!
Next time.
I think.